Hey, what's up? This is Václav. Today, we're diving into the future of open, privacy-focused voice assistants. This is the Home Assistant Voice Preview Edition, the first official voice hardware designed by the creators of the Home Assistant. 8 months ago, I made a video about a voice assistant in a Home Assistant featuring the ESP32 S3 Box 3. So let's compare both and see what sets them apart from their name. I'll focus on the installation, its features and performance in a noisy environment. At $59, this sleek device is built with privacy and usability at its core. It's equipped with dual microphones, an XMOS audio processor and tactile controls, all packed into an injection molded case. It comes in a well-built paper box with the signature lock with the Home Assistant logo on it. It can't deny the same origin as the Home Assistant green or the yellow devices. So let's open the box and let's get started. Setting it up is as simple as powering it up with USB-C, and then I will open Home Assistant mobile app on my phone and it will automatically be discovered via Bluetooth. So I will hit add. And then I need to configure the Wi-Fi. It will configure it into the device. And once this is connected to the internet, it will check for the latest updates and install them. Then it will walk me through the initial configuration where I can change the wake word, configure the area. And if I have more voice assistants configured, I can choose which one to use. And that's really it. Simple. Compare it to the ESP32 box. That one I had to plug it into the computer via USB cable and upload the ESP home firmware first. Then I had to set up the Wi-Fi and then the Home Assistant will discover and the rest will be very similar. This one comes with the firmware already installed, so it is much easier. So now it's been added to Home Assistant, let's open it and check it out. And right away, I can see the first difference. Unlike the S3 box, this one includes a media player. This is really great. It solves one of the two main issues I had with the Home Assistant voice assistant. Let me explain how we use those devices. The first use case, it's obvious. I can ask them to control different devices like toggle the lights or close the gate, ask about the temperature. That uses the voice assistant entities and that works for both from the start. But this is actually the use case I use the least. I prefer that the lights work either automatically or I use the switches on the wall. I find it easier than talking to a voice assistant. Except perhaps for the assistant in the bedroom. When I'm in a bed, it's actually quite convenient to control the house from the bed, other than getting out of the bed and walking somewhere. But more frequently, I use those satellites to get notifications when some scheduled task is finished or something happens. Brána je otevřená už 5 minut. Mám ji zavřít? And then I can follow up with controlling the house.
Jo, zavři bránu, díky.
Brána byla úspěšně zavřena. And these announcements need a media player entity. And this one is now available in the Home Assistant Voice, so that's why I'm so excited about it. But a third scenario, and probably the most use case, is to set a timer or alarm clock.
OK, Nabu. Nastav časovač na 10 vteřin.
Nastavil jsem časovač na 10 vteřin.
Stop.
I can set up a timer, but this one lives on the voice assistant satellite. Home Assistant doesn't know about it. But it doesn't work for setting up an alarm for a specific time. So until this is added, I will still use my Google Nest Hubs as a sort of over-engineered alarm clocks.
Hey Google, please set up an alarm for 6:30 in the morning.
All right, your alarm's set for tomorrow at 6:30 a.m.
Thank you.
I'm here to help.
Now that we are comparing the Home Assistant voice assistant to other voice satellites, their biggest advantage is local processing of the voice. It keeps data private and allows offline operations. For supported languages, that is. This works great for English and perhaps few other major languages, but my ultimate goal is to use my own native language, Czech. This is why I set up my voice assistant in Czech. But for my language, the local processing is not really usable. Also because of the way the Czech grammar works, the standard keyword-based voice recognition isn't very reliable. I made a video about it, you can check it out, I'll link it in the corner. The words keep changing their form and there are too many variants, so I have to remember which way to say things to trigger the right action, and it sucks, really. Luckily, there is the option to use LLMs. They do not really rely on specific keywords, they understand the language based on the vectors. But for the LLMs, I need the cloud anyway. Unless I have a quite powerful hardware, but I'd like to run Home Assistant on a device with reasonable power consumption. So for me, the local processing is not really the thing. Not for the voice anyway. And as for the data privacy, I use a paid AI subscription that hopefully guarantees that. So, with this out of the way, let's continue with the device review. It features advanced audio processing, including echo cancellation and noise removal. So it ensures it hears you clearly, even in challenging condition. That's great, let's test it. Let's compare it to the ESP32 S3 Box device. I'll give the same command across the room in a quiet environment, and then I will turn on the music and see how they perform, how they understand. First, the ESP32 S3 Box 3.
OK, Nabu. Zhasni světlo v obýváku. OK, Nabu. Rozsvít pravé světlo v obýváku.
Okay, that worked. But now turn on the music and let's see if it can still perform.
Okay, Nabu. Okay, Nabu. Okay, Nabu. Zhasni světlo v obýváku. Okay, Nabu. OK, Nabu. Zhasni světlo v obýváku.
OK, so that didn't work. Let's see if the Home Assistant voice performs better.
OK, Nabu. Zhasni světlo v obýváku.
Alright, so it worked flawlessly, even with the 3D printer running in the background. Let's turn the volume up and try again.
Okay, Nabu. Okay, Nabu. Zhasni světlo v obýváku.
So, the advanced audio processing of the Home Assistant Voice Preview Edition is a clear winner. Even with the high background noise, it captures the wake word and executes the command without issue. So that's great. What else? It's expandable with the sensors via the groove port and it's fully open for modding. that sets it apart from the other consumer voice satellites. The advanced users can add custom sensors and customize it in any way they want. In fact, if I do not want to use it as a voice assistant, I can load a custom ESP home firmware on it and reuse it to do anything I like. That's neat.
And then there is this tactile control with a quite satisfying clicks. I can use it to control the volume, and when I turn it all the way down, it will turn into red. And I can use the middle button instead of the wake word.
Rozsviť pravé světlo v obýváku.
Pravé světlo v obýváku bylo rozsvíceno.
So, this was the Home Assistant Voice Preview Edition. It is easy to install. It comes with a built-in media player. It performs better in noisy environments. It is fully customizable, and for supported languages, it champions local processing and data privacy. All for $59. It's a fantastic addition to anyone looking to integrate voice control into their smart home. In my previous video, I got a question about the ESP32 S3 box, and I did not answer that because I think this device is a much better option. So, that's it for today's video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!